Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I want to make sure you're aware that I am planning to give C++ best practices workshops at several conferences coming up this year, including ACCU Bristol in March, C++ on C in Folkestone, England in June. In this episode, I want to talk about the difference between a requires clause and a requires expression. This episode is sponsored by JetBrains, and I wanted to let you know that I do personally use CLion in my work. I find the refactoring tools to be particularly valuable. The safe delete feature has saved me a ton of time when I've been doing refactoring on large projects. I can get analysis of my compile time checks and see when something is wrong or fails to compile right here in my IDE. So be sure to check out the links in the video description for a discount code and more information about how you can check out CLion. This is simply a constant expression that returns a Boolean. Requires expressions test to see if code is valid. This is a pretty loose definition of this, but it's a good working definition for right now. So in my requires expression, I can say, pretend like I have an object called I of type int. And then I can ask the question, is it valid code to increment this integer? This code will compile and it will return true because it is valid to increment a non-const int. Now, if I make this a const int, this code's gonna fail to compile, which isn't how those of us who know anything about requires expressions would expect this to work. We would expect this to simply return false because I am not allowed to increment a const integer. To get the most benefit from requires, this effectively has to be inside of a template. Now I am asking if it is valid to increment a const integer, and I'm going to get 0 returned from main here. If I remove the constness from here, then I am going to get the answer back, yes, it is valid to increment an integer. Note, I am not incrementing an integer. I am asking a question. You can use requires clauses on lambdas, on regular functions, on member functions, on classes, etc. I've just created a function that is uncallable, except they must always be on templates. I'm going to now get an error saying that I have no matching function overload for this call to my func. If I make this true, then I have no constraints here. And you could play some interesting games with literally just using true and false to remove certain versions of the function from the overload set, but I don't know if that's wise or not. Point being, this takes a Boolean constant expression. This can be any constant expression. I am now back again to a function that cannot be called. The rules about where parentheses are required here, I feel like sometimes feels a little arbitrary. I am actually executing this code at compile time called getValue. This returns a Boolean, which is false. And so then my requires becomes false. And therefore this function is not callable. I can change this to return true. And I'm back in the situation where I was, where we had hard coded true and false in these two places. So why might you actually want this? And you're probably going to want it for things like concepts. And we have some concepts from the standard library. I can do something like this. I can require that the thing that is being passed to this function be an integral type. This is one of the most straightforward examples that I can use here. If I pass it a floating point type, I have no overload match. This fails to compile. There are four different places that constraints can be used. I'm not going to get into the details of constraints. I am just going to take a minute here to talk about requires clause versus requires expression, as we already said. So this thing expects a Boolean, and I just gave it a concept. Well, I can here use a requires expression if I so wanted to. I am now asking the question, is it valid to increment something of type t here? So now when I call this thing, can you increment a value of type int? Yes, you can. This function is callable. Can I increment something of type boolean? No, I cannot. Therefore, this function is not callable. It does not meet the constraints here. So that is requires clause, as I said, expects a Boolean constant expression, and the requires expression is a Boolean that asks a question. So this code is compilable how it is. This is a ad hoc concept that I've created. It's probably a code smell. You probably should have created a formal concept instead. But now you see how we get to requires requires. That is a requires clause. That is executing a requires expression. And this is how these two things can go together. You can play some interesting games if you know the fact that a requires expression just returns a Boolean, and that can be used in if constexpr, and I have done videos about that before, and I have also done videos about requires requires. But I thought this would be a good opportunity to clear up the differences between requires clauses and requires expression, and it's always good to revisit these topics from time to time. So thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope to see you in one of my upcoming best practices classes, or hear from you if you're interested in having any other type of C++ training at your organization.